about to see
how you doing today, Warped Tour.
We have an interview with him as well. Make sure to check that out. We also have Reliant K on the show, Story of the Year, and more. So stay tuned to Concert Pipeline.
We are the Colored Friend. We came all the way from Philadelphia, and I've been waiting all year for this tour. Today's the second day.
Where the Dead Milkmen and people probably the the Hooters and Bam Margera are all from that area.
Yeah, you been hanging out with Bam?
Occasionally. We knew him when he was a kid, and he was the best skater, even though he was 7 years younger than us. So
yeah.
That's how I remember him. I still see him around town.
You do some skating yourself?
Yeah, especially when I was... I just recently injured my ankle, so I haven't been doing it the last 6 months. But I like riding around. I'm not a big trick guy, but I pop around on it, you know.
How'd the ankle injury come around?
It was more like loading. I was getting ready for a show, and I was running through the rain. Nothing too exciting, but I think I need an operation because it hurts as much now as it did the day I did it, so kind of bad.
You gonna be able to get by here on Warped Tour?
You know what? You just gotta brave it. I got a brace on it and I just go out. I think that's why it's not getting any better, because since I've done it, I haven't been home from tour. We did like 4 months straight and then right into this, which is 2 months, so. I can't complain. I got, for the job I'm doing, I can take little injuries.
Yeah.
I stabbed myself in the leg, by the way, on the last tour. I was cutting something. And let me just tell you, always cut away from you. I was cutting toward me. I was in an angle, I couldn't get the knife in, and it broke, went right into my leg. Actually, I was wearing these pants.
Yeah, let me see them.
And it went in about that deep. Not a good day for me. I was at the hospital.
Yeah. Well, you're on Warped Tour. It's obviously just started. How have the shows gone so far? Have you done?
We played yesterday, and it was amazing. When I started this band back in the fall, my goal for the year was to get out here on Warped Tour and get the word out that way, because not only is it the best way to get out your new band, but it's the funnest, like, it's the coolest way to introduce your band. Trying to stand out from all these bands, they're all competing to get your attention, and so we all fight harder for it. I feel like I see a lot of the bands, you can tell they're fighting for the crowd every day.
They are. And how do you think this year's Warped Tour is going to be different than the Warped Tours you've done in the past?
Well, it's a lot different for me just because of the people that I'm with, and of course, we're a much newer band, so when I did the Warped Tour in 2004 with Take It Back Sunday, we were considered one of the headliners, and it certainly is not the case this time. We're definitely playing for some people who are hearing us for the very first time. So it's a whole different challenge, but I welcome a challenge. I enjoy it. I'm ready for this summer.
Oh, totally. It's going to be a hot one.
Oh. It already is. I mean, you think this is bad. This is mild. Yesterday it was like 113 down in Pomona.
So
it's in Arizona's after this.
Do you have a lot of Take Back Sunday fans following your current
tour? Yeah, there's a lot of familiar faces around the country, which is kind of neat because every town we go to, there's 5 or 10 kids. I'm like, I know you guys. I've seen you come out to the shows for years, and that helps a lot. Having that familiarity, and I'm so happy when they say that they like the new stuff, because even though I did write a lot in Take It Back Sunday, I wanted to be sure. I really wanted to write something this time that they would still love, and I tried to do it in that same spirit, and hopefully it falls in the same vein for people.
Yeah, I get the feeling of Take It Back Sunday from your new album.
Okay.
Actually,
good.
So it's probably good to be in the same sort of genre. A lot of bands are changing.
Yeah, like it was started as a solo project, and like most people's solo project is like a harmonica and acoustic guitar, and there's one acoustic song on the record, but in general, it's like very close to what I've done in all my past bands. So if you've heard any of that and liked it, you probably will like this.
How did The Color Friend come about?
I was in a band called Breaking Pangea before Take It Back Sunday, and I started the band then, and I was going to do a record with Equal Vision, who wound up putting out my record this year. This was 5 years ago, and of course I joined TBS, things got really busy, and I kept putting it off. Finally, when it came time to do it, luckily I was able to do it with Equal Vision, and it's sort of like it was worth the wait. It was, but and I'm glad it happened the way we wanted it to.
Yeah. Now I hear you're putting out a documentary, or at least you're working on one.
Yeah, they. I have some friends that are filmmakers, and they made actually our new video for Hate to See You Go out of pieces of that documentary. And they also made our first video for If I Surrender. But the documentary, they followed us around for a week or so on the Angels and Airwaves tour, and they wanted to just get the idea of, like, you know what I'm doing now, you know, life after the old band, and like and how different it is, and things like that. So it came out pretty good. We're still like sending back edits constantly.
Yeah.
I mean, they're making it, but I try to complain about it if I didn't want to change something.
Well, they're not the same without you, so.
No.
Now, I hear that you record in a dark part of your house. Is there a symbolism to that? Or?
Well, I'm usually in my basement, and I'm always doing that at night, usually. Of course, drums usually during the day, but like I'm always up late till all hours of the night, like just remixing and just, I don't know, listening to the songs hundreds of times, trying to get them just right and editing, and that's how I wrote Bend to Break. Was I demoed everything first in my basement, and then went in with Giordano and did it for real.
Okay, and I also heard that you drive in a car that runs on vegetable oil.
This is true.
So tell me about that one.
I have a 1982 Volkswagen Rabbit, and I get grease, really. From the deep fryer, and I take it home, and I filter it, and put it in my car, and it's called a grease car. And I've been running that, you know, it's basically free gas, and more importantly, it's something I wanted to do for the environment. And that's big on that's at the top of the list for the color gray. Like, it's definitely, you know, I wanted to do a band that sort of stood for something, and this is one of the things that we stand up for and try to spread the word about to our fans. Our album cover is actually 90% recycled material, and it's 100% biodegradable.
There we go.
Yeah, this part here, this is a digipack, and so this is all recycled cardboard, and then this part that's normally plastic is cornstarch material, which I think you can eat, maybe.
Take a bite.
And I'm told if you dump it in a bucket of water, it just dissolves, so don't go out in the rain, but this is just part of me not wanting to put a 1,000 pieces of plastic out in the world with my name on it. I think we all need to think about the impact we have by the little things we do. And so I just made a decision to do it, and it came out a lot better, I think.
Yeah. Now, when you went to record Bend to Break, was that completely solo, or did your bandmates have a part?
Steve Curtis, my drummer, played on the record, and I played the bass guitar, keys and stuff. I had a friend play piano on the song It Isn't Me. Clint Stelbach's actually from Breaking Pangea. But I mainly played everything and sang everything. So I had some friends help out, but you're basically getting all me plus our drummer. I didn't play the drums.
No.
I do play, but Steve's a lot better than I am.
Now back to Warped Tour for a minute. Tell me some experiences from the past that you've had on Warped Tour, things that stand out.
Man, my favorite times of Warped is like how many bands are here. You definitely find like a good 35 people, like Dave Kennedy from Angels and Airwaves, and that you just want to sit around and hang out with and talk to every day. There's never a shortage of that, which is nice. I made so many friends that I've kept, and he's one of them, actually. Because 2004, when I played, just sat and ate lunch with that guy every single day. And you make those friendships for life. It's really amazing.
So overall, I just think that's a state of the music industry just been great to me.
Has it been great to you?
Have a good show.
Goodbye.
That's another one of them.
Another one of those Angels and Airwaves.
He's not my friend, though.
No,
I just got off tour with that That crazy person.
That crazy guy. Where do you stay cool in at Warped Tour?
Oh man, there is nowhere, honestly. You know, we have a bus, and sometimes it's parked too far away to hang out in. So they have these tents everywhere. You know, 4 years ago when I did the tour, there were only a couple bands that had tents, but people are learning along the way, and every single bus has a tent now, or and some of them have these big monstrous ones that they set up tables under and hang out and drink and do all the games. PA systems playing classic rock, it's a whole different scene. People are coming more prepared, which is pretty neat. It makes it more fun.
Yeah. How do you afford tour gas? You know, you guys?
Oh my God, it is the killer this year. In fact, you know, a lot of bands are wondering how they're going to keep doing this because, you know, like I know of some of the bigger bands on the tour who are planning on going in two buses and cut it down to one, even though they may have 14 or 15 people, because they couldn't pay for the gas. It's, I mean, when your tour budget goes up that amount of percentage, I mean, it's double the amount of gas from what we spent, you know, in 2004. It's terrible. It's hurting us.
Yeah. Okay, now, tell me about a typical day for you on Warped Tour.
Well, I'm actually my own tour manager. I have a merch guy and another friend helping out. But the band, man, we work hard. We get up about 7 o'clock, run out. Merch guy gets a tent set up. I go get the passes and guest list and make sure and find out what time we're playing, because you never find out till the day of. So that's the other thing. There is no typical day, because yesterday I played at 6. Today I was supposed to play at 10 a.m. So you never know when you're going to play. I'm actually playing a little later, but like the schedule changes so much.
Yeah.
It's hard to get into a routine.
It is. That's the fun in it, right? You know,
it's
living life on
it. Yeah, it hopefully goes by quicker because I can't be complacent or settled or relaxed at all.
Yeah, cool. Well, Fred, thanks for doing the interview.
Oh, my pleasure.
Make sure to check out The Color Fred on Concert Pipeline.
What's up? I'm Fred from The Color Fred, and you're watching Concert Pipeline. Ow!
Pipeline here with John Schnick and Matt Hoops from Reliant K. How are you guys doing today?
Great, man. How you doing?
Going good. Okay. And how's the Warped Tour going for you so far? You've only had a couple days, obviously, but...
Yeah, it's been awesome. The first day was hot. It's a little warm now, but yeah, just kind of settling in and getting everything down. So yeah, it's great.
Yeah. Now, you're going to love this weather, I'm sure, because it's only going to get hotter from here, right?
Yeah, absolutely.
Where on Warped Tour do you go to keep cool?
The bus is really the only place you can go to keep cool.
Now, you guys were nominated for a Grammy in 2003. Tell me about how that made you feel.
Well, it was for a very small category, so we tried to, you know, take it for what it was, but it's still very prestigious to even be, to say you're nominated for a Grammy, so it's a, you know, we're lucky to do that, but, you know, it was fun to go there, but it wasn't anything.
Well, you guys started out 10 years ago, you know? How have you guys grown? How has Reliant K changed since 98?
Well, we've added a lot of new members, John and John, and most recently Ethan, our drummer. So we're customs in Canada, and we all got off, got back on the bus, drove about 30 miles into the United States, and realized we left our bass player in Canada, and we had to go back again. That was pretty funny.
It's one of those almost famous stories, right?
Exactly.
Yeah. He's that guy back there in the black shirt.
Yeah.
I bet he didn't appreciate that.
He didn't. It was no good. He made a pit stop and didn't get back up.
He paid the price.
He did. That was just a warning. Next time we're watching anything. Now, what was your favorite tour you guys have done?
I think it's kind of one of those things where you take away something from every tour. They all seem to kind of get better as we go along. The last tour, big tour, was the Switchfoot. That one was really cool because, you know, they're really good friends of ours. Kind of try to take the best from each tour that we can and just learn from it.
Now you guys, I know you guys have done a lot of stuff with Switchfoot. How did that friendship, partnership come about?
I guess you guys met them way back when, before I was in the band.
I mean, we played shows with them before we were signed, even when they were on tour with Five Iron Frenzy.
Yeah.
We would try to get on the show, so we've known them forever, and they've always just been super nice, humble guys from when they were touring in a mini band to now where they're, you know, have some multi-platinum records and, you know, have done well. So they're really, really uplifting guys to be around just all day, you know, just hang out. It's fun to work.
Very cool. Now, I know you guys have kind of a unique story about your bus catching on fire. You want to tell me about that a little bit, or is it a sore subject?
Although we still haven't gotten reimbursed for anything.
Yeah, that's the only sore part. We were in Pennsylvania driving down the turnpike, and I was asleep, and the bus driver just runs in the back and just tells everybody to get off the bus, and he says it was on fire. And so we got off the bus and literally just watched it burn down. So.
You guys lost a lot, right? Like, you guys lost a computer with songs in it or something?
Yeah, we lost a lot of personal stuff and some of the band stuff too as well. But, you know, everybody made it out, so that was unfortunate.
Yeah. And you only had to cancel one show after that?
I think we just canceled one show. Yeah, we were on our way to play Cornerstone in Illinois, and we didn't make it. So.
Now, you guys are going to be working on, are you going to be working on the Birds and the B-Sides?
It's done? It comes out on July 1st. July 1st.
I know you have a scavenger hunt kind of attached to that, so where listeners can get free songs. You want to tell me about that a little bit?
Well, we had a few extra songs, actually probably more like 20, that we couldn't fit on the record because of time constraints.
Yeah.
And they were just older, you know, songs that we never used on records, so we decided to put maybe some three of the better songs out there, and people can just go and download them, and you figure out the riddle, which is probably not too hard.
Really?
I haven't tried it.
You guys play those songs on stage sometimes?
Actually, I don't know if we've ever played the first two of the three downloads. I don't think we've ever played.
Just holding them in for later? Or just?
I don't know. They never really had a full place on their own before, so I don't know if they'll ever pop up as having a place, but, you know, I think they're good songs, and we just wanted to put them out there for people who want to listen to them.
And what's a typical day on Warped Tour for you?
Today we got up, played the show, and kind of just hanging out right now. Yeah, it's fun because you can watch bands if you want, you can go to a city if you want. You know, a lot of people to hang out with.
Yeah, totally.
Yeah.
Cool. Well, Matt, John, thank you guys for coming in today. And check out Reliant K.
Hey, what's up? This is John and Matt from Reliant K, and you're watching Concert Pipeline.
Play the guitar for a bit, then we play a show, then we do press, then we do a signing, then we started drinking beer again.
Very cool. Yeah. And what are some experiences on the Warped Tour that you enjoy? Some memories?
Seriously, just every night, just when everyone hangs out at night after everyone's done with the show, and everyone just kind of hangs out in the bus area. And, I don't know. It's just like the best time. Everyone just sits around underneath their tent, just hangs out. It's great.
Are you guys gonna be recording again soon?
Or? No, not for another year. So. No, I'm gonna tour. Then maybe take a little time off then.
Do you have your next tour planned after Warped Tour?
Yeah, we do Warped, and then we take a couple weeks off, and then we do Taste the Chaos International. And after that, we'll do probably a headlining tour in the States. And after that, we'll do a headlining tour overseas again. And then I think it'll be like springtime by then, so or next summer by then. So.
Do you find that international audiences are different than audiences here in the U.S.?
It's a little different, yeah. They're a little... People in the U.S., especially like on the West Coast, are so bombarded with music. It's so saturated with music. Like everywhere you turn, it's like some band coming at you, you know. And a lot of like bands don't make it over to like Australia and like Belgium and places like that, you know. So I think they're a little more excited for music, you know. There's not a you know 10 shows a night. It's Ryan from Story of the Year. You're watching Concert Pipeline.
Thank you all for watching Concert Pipeline today. I want to send a big thank you out to The Color Fred, Fred from Taking Back Sunday, Reliant K, and Story of the Year, all for being on the program. Hope you enjoyed it, and tune in next time. Have a good night.